not a classical guy, so I'm a novice at it. I just happen to be the right guy at the right time.
My dream has always been to combine the sound of the acoustic piano to the sound of synthesizers.
When I started adding real instrumentation and techno music, a lot of people got upset about it because they thought techno was supposed to be this pure form of synthesized music. It really isn't. Techno is about the attitude.
There would not be an electronic music without an acoustic music.
When we speak about classical music, like, what are we talking about? That's at least like 500 years of music. That's even much more different than, let's say, death metal and salsa.
If you talk about electronic music, I'm mainly thinking of like this purely, completely synthesized stuff. But I think that many people who use the word, they just don't really, they use it for a really big time frame and a really big thing of genres and styles too, like the same with the word classical music.
We always get asked to define something, but like the beauty definitely doesn't lay in this. The beauty is just in this open bubble where you don't need to define it all. Somebody would tell me, yeah, there's this music, it's classical mixed with techno. I wouldn't really know what I would imagine. I would imagine maybe Für Elise from Beethoven and a techno beat underneath.
Okay, yeah, let's try it.
And you got some classical techno.
Those ducks are insane. Have you seen those before? There were times where I was really unhappy with everything I was writing, so I thought maybe I would not be a writer of music. And now I just kind of keep doing it because I'm enjoying it, and I don't really do anything else very well. I never sit down and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna write a song. Is it gonna be electroacoustic, or is it gonna be like just acoustic?
I can hear a step. You wonder why they're so still all able.
Now you have people processing instruments, and sometimes it's cool. Obviously, like, that's what we're doing in this performance.
Run so quickly beside them. Could it be a dance for them? Don't to be too.
In many ways, it's a feeling. I stop when I feel now it's just right. Now it vibrates freely. Now it sounds the way I want it. Like when I tap the finished plates, for example, or on the arching when I see, now it's, this is the right kind of arching for this instrument.
Beethoven. He was here for a long time, and he walked all the fields and all the forests. And so every path is called Wanderweg, Beethoven Wanderweg. He was living here. He wrote his 9th symphony in Baden. Freude schöner Götterfunken, Tochter aus Elysium. Nice, huh? Isn't that beautiful? That was my tape studio in Germany before we left for Austria. I met people in Berlin like Konrad Schnitzler, Ashra Tempel, Klaus Schulze, Edgar Fröse, Tangerine Dream. We became friends, and we decided to do musical projects. It was a concert where I was invited in Lanzarote by Brian Eno. I'm aware of the stuff I'm using, the keyboards, or whether it's a piano. The piano is the most interesting instrument for me. I just let it come, and so a piece develops by itself. It's in the time of the Zodiac, so it's 60 and early 70s. From the first moment on, this place was crowded with people from everywhere. It was an empty room in general, and the amplification system, of course, to be able to make a lot of noise.
On a piano and in the whole Baroque music, you learn a lot about the 12-tone scale. The whole thinking of the Western world is defined in the 12-tone scale. If you hear arabesque music from our Turkish neighbors, they have another scale and it sounds completely different. You can free yourself from that, for instance, with innovations like such an instrument.
If you can play a chord on a keyboard, you can do the same here, but you can shrink it.
I don't know what's classical music. I've never come across a remotely satisfying definition of it. I know the term has been coined in around 1850 to designate music that was about 100 years old. So in 1850, the music of 1750 was classical. All classical music has been contemporary at some point. And I really don't know what's classical and what's not. So I'd rather talk of acoustic music.
Also ich habe jetzt hier geschrieben zwischen 80 und 160, das sind so die Metronomzahlen, die irgendwie Sinn machen. Dann ist ja das eigentlich das Tempo, das ich fühle. Vom Feeling her. Und dann würde ich aber sagen, das Feeling ist halt zwei Klicks. Dann mache ich macht, ne? Macht das DRW?
To use classical techniques or classical instruments is just gives us more possibilities to do something.
Mach jetzt mal einfach auf alle Töne immer was drauf. Einfach so, dass du schnell und gar nicht groß überlegen kannst, welcher Ton kommt, dann einfach so spontan irgendwelche, okay. Weißt du? Ja, Mann. Man muss erst was aufbauen, dann kann man es wieder kaputt machen. Ne? Kennst du ja.
Not about being difficult. If you do very simple things, that's pop music, because it's beautiful
without it being difficult to play.
Some of these things, like this one, I think it came in multiple parts because they had like a little computer screen that went with it. I think the first time I saw it, maybe it was like in a Thomas Dolby video or something, but when I was in ninth grade, Stevie Wonder came to my school and performed, and he had one, and that was like, I was more interested in that than I was in Stevie Wonder.
Interesting work comes when I get away from the keyboard and I'm at the desk, or I'm maybe turning the knobs and the faders and not so much the keyboard anymore, because when I play the keyboard, it's basically too easy.
The spirit of Detroit is in me, and the spirit of Detroit is pretty much unlike anywhere else, because we're so militant about, you know, doing what we want to do and being independent.
Debussy, the French composer, said that the music is not so much defined by the notes as it is defined by the silence in between those notes. So you cannot have music which is only action. You have to have the reaction time, which is basically the timeout in between the pitches.
Detroit is about not following the masses. It's about really, you know, writing your own story.
When I listen to radio or to what's happening in the clubs, and I hear it's always the same. Mainstream services people's expectations, and we don't serve expectations. We just open expectations with what we are doing.
I don't think it's healthy to think about why you're relevant. I think it's better to just be kind of doing what you want to do and not thinking about how you fit in within the context of the music world.
I don't do my music by purpose. I don't want to be rich. I don't want to be famous. I'm just doing it because I love it.
If I ever think I have understood what music is and should be, then I did something wrong.
We're not trying to make sense or anything. We're just trying to make you wake up, and that's all it's about. It's about waking up your ears, waking up your senses, and wake up to the surroundings of your life.
I mean, after 40 years doing it, I'm rather proud that it really works, because it was such a risk from the beginning. Nobody knew what he did. We just tried out to find something which pleased us and the public. In the beginning, it was pure actionism.